Valorant is a game all about skill gaps, so can switching from right-handed to left-handed improve my aim and help me get to my next rank? First thing I did was hop into the range and switch my handedness to left.
Oh, this feels super weird. The knife alone this feels weird.
I did a quick warm-up drill, then headed into a deathmatch before I played comp.
Hold on though, this kind of feels a little crispy. Oh my god, hold on. Whoops. Found the spot.
That's three. After the deathmatch, I queued into comp and got matched into sunset. Since Jett was already taken, I picked Chamber because he used to be my main back in episode 5.
I love the young
people. Defenders win. We ended up losing that game, and I played okay, considering the fact that I was playing on a new setting as well. But since I'm still feeling pretty good, I decided to queue into another game.
Fuck me, god damn it. Got the job done, baby.
CT and Hookah, outside of
TV. Yeah.
One enemy remaining.
Oh my god, Jack. This is better.
Oh my god.
Slay him! Oh god. 48.
Oh, he doesn't have it.
Oh, yeah, we lost. Oh, we won.
Attackers win.
Oh, yeah. Heart stuck plat 3, baby.
Coming off a match MVP and a rank up back to plat 3, I was looking to continue this momentum into my next games. However, the duality of Valorant is going from a match MVP to being 5-11, 15 rounds in your very next game. This was one of those games where I could get nothing going, no flow, my aim felt terrible, and this cypher was just dunking on me. So was everyone else in the lobby. I really wanted to salvage my performance and help my team close out the game, so for these last two rounds I tried to really lock in, and they ended up being my best of the whole match.
Attackers win.
Outrun me? Was that supposed to be a fight?
Damn, I was playing so bad, and then I just picked it up. I don't know. I just locked in, I think. I hit 140. Oh, they're up mid, they're up mid. What the? Guys. Let's go B fast.
One enemy remaining.
Run. No.
One enemy remaining.
My jeez. Almost I almost tossed it at the end right there. Oh my god. MVP. Fuck, I only got team MVP.
With another MVP under my belt, I was getting more comfortable with the left-handed setting. But as I mentioned before, the duality of Valorant can be very unforgiving. This game on Abyss was the complete opposite of the previous game. Everything was just not working. I could not kill a damn thing. Our team was getting steamrolled. Everything that comes with being hard stuck plat 3. I think I went like 4-13. We lost 3-13. Just a terrible game. I'm not even going to blame this on the left-handed setting. This was just bad. This next game, playing Neon on Haven. And after a couple competitive rounds in this match, we ended up having an AFK on our team. And it was too much for us to overcome to come back and win the game. We made it competitive, but it was just too much of a disadvantage to go 4v5 every round. However, the Cypher that was on my team decided to add me and my duo and asked if he could queue up with us for our next game. We said yeah, and this is what happened.
Just right click him.
Yeah!
GG.
Defenders win.
With the power of friendship, we win that game 13-3, giving us back some RR from the AFK game right before that. Overall, as a team, we all played cohesively, everyone did their jobs, and that resulted in a nice win. Overall, the left-handedness setting is a cool thing to do if you feel like switching it up, or if it's what your eyes just prefer. I don't see too much of a difference for myself, so I think it will be something I just turn on for fun, or if I feel like my aim is bad and I just want to switch. But other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.